Kids, welcome to Kids Church. I'm Miss Melissa, and I'm so glad you're here with me today. Quick review. This month, we're talking about go. Where are we going? That's right. We're going into the world to live for Jesus and share Jesus with other people. Last week, we talked about putting on the armor of God. The armor of God protects us. This week, we're going to be talking about how God protects our hearts and our minds. So, how does God protect our hearts and our minds? What does that mean? Today, we're going to look at a story of a man named Paul. I'll tell you more about him in a second. But first, let's read Philippians 4:4-9. It says, "Be full of joy in the Lord always. I will say it again, be full of joy. Let all men see that you are gentle and kind. The Lord is coming soon. Do not worry about anything, but pray and ask God for everything you need. And when you pray, always give thanks, and God's peace will keep your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. The peace that God gives is so great that we cannot understand it. Continue to think about things that are good and worthy of praise. Think about things that are true and honorable and right and pure and beautiful and respected. And do what you learned and received from me. Do what I told you and what you saw me do, and the God who gives you peace will be with you." Did you notice in the very beginning it says, "Be full of joy in the Lord always"? It even says it twice. What do you think someone who is full of joy would look like? Can you show me a joyful face? Here's a question for you. Where do you think Paul was when he wrote this letter? Some of you might think he was writing this from his house, or maybe while he was visiting with his friends. But guess what? Paul was in jail. He was in jail for telling people about Jesus, and a lot of people weren't too happy about that back in those days. I don't know about you, but if that had happened to me, I don't think I would have been full of joy. We'll find out more about how Paul could be full of joy, even in jail, in a little bit. But first, let's watch this video together.
Hey! I'm glad you're here today. Were you excited to come? I hope you were. Sometimes we have to go places we're not very excited to visit. So it's fun to go on journeys to fun places. But do you know what? I know a story about a guy named Paul who once went on a very difficult journey. It was scary at first, but Paul found a way to be joyful, even when things were scary and not fun at all. Do you want to hear the story? Great! Paul was a man who went all over the world and told lots of people about Jesus. But then Paul was put in prison because the leaders did not want Paul to talk about Jesus. Scary! But when he was in prison, Paul decided to sing happy, joyful songs to Jesus. You and I might never go to jail for telling people about Jesus, but there might be other reasons why we might feel scared or sad. But when we do, God helps us find joy anyway. Can you show me your happy face? Great job! We can show we are joyful when we trust God to take care of us. Even when we're scared, we can talk to God. Can you hold your hands like you're praying? Great job! Now, can you open your hands like you're reading a book? You did it! The Bible makes a promise that we can have peace and joy when we trust in God. Sometimes our journeys can be difficult, but God still gives us strength to go. Show me your muscles! I know that God will protect my heart and help me be joyful, no matter what happens. I know that God will protect my mind and help me not to worry. God will protect my heart and mind. So let's go!
Let Let's say our verse together, okay? Matthew 5:16. In the same way, you should be a light for other people. Live so that they will see the good things you do. Live so that they will praise your Father in heaven. Great job. Hey, I have an idea. Let's play a game while we practice, okay? This is how it's gonna work. So I'm gonna face away from you and I'll start to say the verse. So you'll need to go stand all the way across on the other side of the room and then start walking toward the screen while I'm not looking, okay? So I'm gonna be like this. Then when I turn around, you're gonna freeze where you're at and say the next word. So I'll start saying the verse this way. Then when I pause and turn around, you say the next word. But you gotta freeze. So if I say this way, you should be a, and I turn around, you say light, because that's the next word in the verse, okay? So let's see if you can get all the way across the room to me before I finish saying the verse, okay? No cheating, all right? Go all the way across the room. Are you ready? Okay, Matthew 5:16. Did you get that? All right, let's keep going. In the same way, you should be a light for other people. Live so that they will see the good things you do. Live so that they will praise your Father in heaven. Great. Did you guys get all the way across the room? Did you remember the words? Good job. Should we play it again? All right. One more time. Go all the way across the room again. Okay, are you ready? All right. Matthew 5:16. In the same way, you should be a light for other people. Live so that they will see the good things you do. Live so that they will praise your Father in heaven. Okay, how'd you do? Did you remember it? Did you get all the way across the room? Okay, thanks for playing. Hey kids, we're gonna have some fun drawing together. So why don't you all go grab a piece of paper and either a pencil or a crayon or something to draw with, and I'll wait while you go grab that and get ready, okay? Okay, go, paper and something to write with. Okay, is everyone back? Got your paper and something to write with? Okay, I'm gonna show you right here what you need to do, okay? Okay, let's draw a small circle together. Now draw a line down from that. Next, we'll draw two short lines. So it almost looks like the legs on a little man. Got that? Now, everyone switch hands. Put the pencil or crayon in your other hand, the hand you don't usually draw with, okay? It might feel a little bit weird, but let's continue drawing with our opposite hand. So let's draw a circle around everything. Now we need to draw kind of a half a circle on top of that, kind of like a rainbow, up and down. Starting at the very top, draw a curvy line that comes in and goes back out again and comes in at the bottom of the big circle. And we'll do another curvy line, kind of the same, starting at the top, coming in, going back out and down again on the other side. Now we need one little arch over here and a little arch inside, up and down, see that? And then we're gonna do another big arch right here, and a little arch inside. Everyone got that? Now we're going to color in the little arch. And we're going to color in this little arch on this side as well. And now, how about we color in that first circle we drew too? And now, all we need are some dots. We'll do three dots over here. One, two, three. And we'll do three dots over here. One, two, three. There! You drew a dog. How did that turn out for you? Was it hard or easy to draw with your opposite hand? Did you really have to focus on making the line go the way you wanted it to go? In our story today, we're going to find out that Paul and his friend Silas did the opposite thing of what most people would do when they were put into prison. They chose to focus on God and everything God had done, instead of focusing on their circumstances. I'm sure it was hard to react in the opposite way than they normally would have, just like it was harder to draw with our opposite hands. But as they focused on God, He protected their hearts and their minds. Come with me while Connor, Tori, and Lizzie help me tell the story. All right, hi kids. I'm gonna tell you a story, and I have Connor and Tori and Lizzie here to help me, all right? And this is a story you can read for yourselves in the Bible in Acts 16. So, once there was a man named Paul and a man named Silas. So Paul and Silas, wave to our friends at home. Wave, Paul and Silas, wave. Paul and Silas were followers of Jesus, and they were on the mission to go. And they loved to tell everyone that Jesus loved them. You guys want to tell everyone that Jesus loves them?
No.
No? Okay. Well, Paul and Silas told everyone that Jesus loved them. And they went, yep, just like that, they went traveling all over telling people about Jesus. Then there were some people that didn't want to hear about that. And they got an angry group that got together and said, Paul and Silas are stirring up trouble in our cities. And so the city officials said Paul and Silas had to be beaten. We're not going to act that part out. And then they got thrown in jail. So our jailer is going to throw them in jail. Come on, jailer. Let's put Paul and Silas in jail. So Paul and Silas are going into jail. Now, once our jailer got Paul and Silas, he put them in the very back of the jail because he didn't want them to escape. And he put their feet, even chained their feet up, so they were stuck for sure. Well, then the jailer laid down and went to sleep because it was nighttime. And then Paul and Silas were awake at midnight, in the middle of the night. And do you know what? Paul and Silas, they could have been angry or sad or maybe even crying because they were in a lot of pain from being beaten. But you know what? Paul and Silas did the opposite of all of that. Paul and Silas were singing, and they were praying to God. They were singing, and the other prisoners were listening to them. Okay, Paul and Silas, let's sing together, okay? And our friends at home are going to hear us. Ready? Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Just like that, Paul and Silas were singing. Well, right about midnight, there was a huge earthquake, and everything shook. But it wasn't just an ordinary earthquake. This earthquake made all the doors of the jail open, and their chains that they had been chained up with fell off. Now, the jailer woke up, and he was very afraid because it was his job to keep those prisoners safe. And he thought, oh no, they have all escaped. So he jumped up and he grabbed his sword and, he was ready to kill himself. But Paul and Silas saw that and they said, no, we're here. No one has left. Now, the jailer went and talked to Paul and Silas. He went to them and said,
What do I need to do to be saved? And Paul and Silas were ready to tell the jailer all about Jesus. And they told him, you must believe in the Lord Jesus and you will be saved. And that is just what happened. The end. So kids at home, you just heard our story. Do you want to act it out with us? Find a place you can hide under and you can go to jail too. All right, we're going to tell our story again, and this time you acted out at home with us, okay? All right, so this time Connor is going to be Paul, and Miss Tori is going to be our jailer. Who are you going to be in our story? Okay, so in our story started, remember, when Paul and Silas were traveling around on their mission to go, and they were telling all the people that Jesus loved them. All right, want to tell everyone that Jesus loved them?
Jesus loved them.
That's right, just like that. And they were telling everyone the good news. Now, remember, there were some people in our story that were unhappy about that. They did not want Paul and Silas telling people about Jesus. And so they grabbed them, they took them to the authorities, and the people of the city said, you have to get beaten and thrown into jail. No beating your brother or sister at home. We won't beat you either. But you will get thrown in jail. All right, jailer, let's put Paul and Silas in jail. All right, in jail you go. All right, so Paul and Silas, remember, got put in the very back of the jail. And they got chained up. Their feet were all chained up. They were locked in. And our jailer lays down and goes to sleep. All right. Now, what were Paul and Silas doing in jail? Were they angry? Were they being sad? What were Paul and Silas doing in jail? Do you guys remember what Paul and Silas were doing in jail? Mm-hmm. What were they doing?
They were sitting.
They were sitting. What else were they doing?
Singing.
They were singing. That's right. They were singing and they were praying to God. They were doing the opposite of what you would expect someone to do in jail. All right, should we sing? You guys sing at home. Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Now remember, at midnight, there was a huge earthquake, and everything shook, but it wasn't a normal earthquake. This earthquake made all the doors come unlocked and open, and their chains came off their feet. Now, the jailer woke up. All right, jailers, if you're a jailer at home, time to wake up. And that jailer saw that all the doors were open, and that jailer thought, oh no, all the prisoners have escaped, and I'm in big trouble. And they pulled the sword out to kill themselves, right? That's what the jailer was going to do. But Paul and Silas said, no, don't do that. Don't hurt yourself. We're all here. And the jailer said, tell me, what do I need to do to be saved? So jailer, go talk to Paul and Silas. Go and talk to Paul and Silas.
Go in.
That's right. You gotta talk to Paul and Silas. And Paul and Silas told the jailer, you need to believe in the Lord Jesus Christ and you will be saved. And that is what happened. The end. All right, guys. Thank you, Connor and Tori and Lizzie. And at home, I hope you had fun acting that out with me. I'll see you in a minute.
Yeah.
We've seen how Paul and Silas sang praises and prayed to God in jail. How could they be so full of joy and peace, even in such a scary place? When life is hard, it really can be difficult to be full of joy like Paul tells us to. It can be hard to continue our mission to go, but it is possible. Let's read the next part in Philippians to see if we can discover what helped Paul to be full of joy. Philippians 4:11-13 says, I am telling you this, but it is not because I need anything. I have learned to be satisfied with the things I have and with everything that happens. I know how to live when I am poor, and I know how to live when I have plenty. I have learned the secret of being happy at any time in everything that happens. I have learned to be happy when I have enough to eat and when I do not have enough to eat. I have learned to be happy when I have all that I need, and when I do not have the things that I need. I can do all things through Christ because He gives me strength. Paul says he learned to be satisfied. Satisfied means to be okay and at peace. He said he learned to be that way no matter what. So how did he do that? Did you catch at the end? It says, through Christ. Maybe you've heard that verse before. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Does that mean that through God we'll be able to make an impossible shot in basketball or walk on the ceiling? No. It means that whatever the situation, whether good or bad, if we stay close to Jesus, Jesus will help us. Jesus can bring us joy and peace whether things go our way or not. Jesus will protect our hearts and our minds. Tough times happen in all of our lives sometimes, just like they did with Paul. But just like Paul and Silas, since we have Jesus, we can be joyful no matter what, because God protects our hearts and our minds.
Hi there, little chicken nuggets. It's me, Carl. Welcome to Grow TV.
Welcome to Grow TV. Introducing your host, Carl. And your co-host, Cassie. Where we learn, where we grow, and we talk about Jesus. Once again, welcome to Grow TV.
Welcome, kiddos. Hope you're having a wonderful day. I've recently gotten some letters from you, little chicken nuggets. I'm going to take some time to answer some questions. It's mail time. Alrighty, letter number one. Matt asks, hey Carl, how long can you hold your breath? Well, let's find out. Okay, well that didn't go as planned. And now my head hurts. Number two. Samantha asks, hey Carl, if you could be any animal in the world, what animal would you want to be? Well, Samantha, I've always wanted to be a flamingo, or a gorilla, a wildebeest, a North African crane, red sparrow, Mongolian honey badger, horseshoe crab. But obviously, if I had to choose one, it'd probably be a house cat. Meow. Last but not least, letter number three. I have a feeling this is going to be a good one. Alex says, dear Carl, your face stinks.
Hey Carl, how you doing?
Not so good. I don't want to talk about it.
Carl, it's okay. You can tell me. What happened?
Well, I was sitting there, opening up fan mail. And someone said something that really got me sad.
Oh, that's terrible. What did it say?
I don't know if I could talk about it.
Okay, can you act it out?
Okay.
Your face? Your face stinks?
Yes. Yes!
Oh, wow, that's really mean. I bet they were just kidding. Your face doesn't really stink. By the way, why are you wearing so many sweaters?
Because I'm protecting my heart.
Your heart?
Yes. That main letter made my heart hurt, so I'm wearing all these vests for extra protection.
Carl, I'm not sure it works that way.
Sure it does. Try and hurt me.
I really don't want to do that.
Come on. I want you to.
No, I really...
Do it!
No.
Do it!
Fine.
Oh!
Come on, Carl, I'm sorry, but I do think you can learn from this.
How?
Well, in Philippians, it says God will guard our hearts and our minds.
Really?
Really. God loves you so much, Carl. He promises to protect our minds, and especially our hearts, even though they might hurt sometimes.
Wow, that's really good news.
It is, and God means it. So how do you feel now?
I mean, better. It still hurts. But I am starting to get sweaty, so...
I bet.
Say, how do you know about that verse?
God says to keep his words on our hearts. So to remember God's words, I must read them. So every day, I try to read the Bible.
You do it every day?
I try. Sometimes I forget, but that's okay, as long as I keep trying.
That's good to know.
Yep, and when we get to know God better through the Bible, the more we can trust He's going to protect our hearts and our minds.
So God will protect our hearts and mind? Whoa! That's our big idea! Today's big idea is this. God will protect our hearts and our mind. So let's all say it together on three. One, two, three. God will protect our hearts and our mind! Well, good job, guys. Good job, Cassie.
Thanks, Carl.
Oh!
Thanks for being with me today. Before we go, let's say a prayer together, okay? Dear God, we just thank you that we can trust you to give us joy and peace when things are going great and also when things are hard. Thank you for your goodness to us and for your love. We love you. In Jesus' name, amen. I'll see you back here next week with more adventures of the disciples on their mission to go. See you then. Bye.